Hey everybody, it's Gameragi. We're back with Epic Mickey 2. Last time we finished off Metari's little taking picture side quest thingy, and also Moody, his side quest. And this part is going to be completely devoted to fixing up Autotopia and competing in the races, or so to speak. So anyway, we talked to Gilda over there, who's now dancing. She said we gotta find a garage, and hopefully the gremlin here will help us fix up this area using the garage. I hope. We should be able to.
Another of those pipeworks, eh? Working together should allow us to figure it out.
Okay. Yeah, I know
so
how to do this.
Swap the thinner curtain here. This curtain here. It's really obnoxious, but I'm pretty sure it's acting like a loading screen. yet again. Is it? Wow. There's a chest right here. Okie dokie. What?
Someone thought this was important enough to put it in a chest. You should hang on to it.
Hey, maybe that's the item you exchange with the pearl in Ventrelands. It does look awfully similar. Unless, wait, hang on. Watch the skies. Nope, it's not one of those. Yeah, that's probably what it is. Okay, well, that's what that is. Hello.
Oh dear, the old garage is locked. I need to get in there if I'm going to set this place right. Could you open it, friend? Be careful, there's sensitive equipment inside.
Okay. So yeah, this is the garage. It's kind of hard to see, like, when you're just walking around, it's just... it kind of blends in with the scenery.
Don't worry about it.
Okay, so Oswald's going to try to push that key in,
maybe
but...
Maybe if we spin the tumblers, we can slide the pin through, eh?
Yeah, so while he's holding the key in, we have to spin this big cog on the top to get the tumblers turning. And then it opens! Still kind of glitching out there, but yeah. Costume piece. Oh boy.
This is mine.
Add Doctor shoes. And two little toon cars.
Wonderful. All I need now is scrap metal to clean up the tracks and set up the race.
Uh-oh.
Do you have the scrap metal for me?
Oh, thank God I do.
Hold on. All done. The time trial it is. You must beat Gilda's times to win. And I've seen her race. Good luck. Trust me, you'll need it. You're looking for a race car? It just so happens. I have one over here, but it needs some tires. Hard to race otherwise. If you hunt around Autotopia, you might find some. Try checking for spares in the trunks of the broken race cars. Bring them back, and I'll get this junker up and running toot sweet!
Oh, toot sweet, oh boy! So, we're gonna go on a little adventure searching for tires. And, one thing I wanted to talk about that I kinda didn't talk about when we beat the end of the game is that, there's a lot of weird things that happen in this game that they don't really explain. It's kind of interesting. Like, why was Prescott talking like a pirate when we were fighting him? They never really explain it. And then, what else? Oh yeah, Captain Hook is missing, and nobody explains where he went. But I'm assuming Captain Hook and Prescott have something in common there because they're both. If Prescott's talking like a pirate, and they don't know where Captain Hook is. Maybe Captain Hook is Prescott? I don't know. That's weird. I wouldn't really know how that would work out. So that was kind of weird. And then if you watch to the end of the credits, there was a little scene with the Peets sneaking off. Probably plotting something evil. And they were carrying Prescott with them. So they're definitely setting up an Epic Mickey 3. But I don't quite understand what's going on there. Then again, I guess all that stuff is going to get answered in the sequel. So we will see what we will see, I guess. I just thought it was kind of interesting. They didn't even, like, explain Prescott's little talking like a pirate at all. It's kind of out of the blue. Have I found, like, one tire so far? That's really
this
bad.
This one's mine!
I think you have to go all the way around and hit, like, every painted car. Oh boy. But see how all the broken cars are, like, cleared out of here now? Yep. So we gotta race through here. And I think it costs scrap to race, because he has to fix all the targets you have to hit or something. So I'm hoping I have enough scrap, but we'll see. I forgot you needed so much. Ugh. Ew! Okay, we have two more to go. Gilda, just let me borrow your car, man. This is a pain in the butt. Yeah, this video might be pretty short. The thing is, this took me a really long time because I couldn't find the garage for the longest time. It's just, it doesn't look like a garage. It's just a metallic door. And the gremlin's not even, like, standing there until you get close to him. And he just appears out of nowhere. So it was like, I was looking around for so long. Anyway. No biggie, man. No biggie. We need one more tire. It's probably in here. Somewhere. Not that one. These cars sure are bouncing. Not that one. I think this area gets probably the biggest transformation of any area in the game. Just because it was all, like, disastrous, enemies everywhere. And now it's, like, getting all fixed up so you can actually race in it. It's pretty awesome. Alrighty, so I guess this is the last side quest I want to do. The other ones are just a little bit too tedious for me. I mean, if you're a really big completionist and you have a lot of time on your hands, you could probably do them.
Wait.
Like searching for all the hidden heroes, man, that would be a pain in the butt to do.
Nicely done, Mickey.
But I mean, you can get all the maps to where they are, so like, you could do it without looking up stuff, I guess, which is cool. I like that games do that, where you don't actually have to look stuff up. You could just use in-game stuff. Which is good. That's good. You shouldn't have to look things up to get everything. Like Metroid, where they tell you where all the power-ups are. I think that's an awesome idea. They should do that in like every game. Because if you have to look stuff up to find everything, it's just a pain in the butt.
I see you have the tires I need to fix up that junker over there. I'll get right on it.
How is that supposed to put tires on? Gremlins are weird. Okay, so here we are. We're in our car now. Yeah, this is probably the coolest thing I've seen in an Epic Mickey game so far. Although I gotta admit, the car is very difficult to control. Its handling is awful. And if you hit anything, you just go like bumping around like crazy. Look at this, man. It's so hard to control yourself. Anyway, that's gonna make this next part all the better. Can I get out of here?
Are you sure?
Yes. Practice
You're
race.
You're all set to race.
Race again. I haven't raced the first time. So this is Gilda. She's got this big old hot rod.
Look at that! My best time yet! Beat that! If you can.
Best time yet, huh? Well, okay.
It's your turn! Start your engines!
Oh, they're going!
Ready, set, go!
Okay, so what we have to do is not just race, but we have to break targets, I think. Oh no. Is this actually a race? Wow, okay, the boosting is very bad. Wait, is this a race? What the heck? When I did this, I actually had to break targets. Okay, I'm gonna avoid the boosting. Oh, and the water slows you down, okay. Oh, this is so weird. This is different than when I did it in the last playthrough. I seriously had to drive through a whole bunch of targets that I had to break. Oh my god, I'm not gonna make it. 5 seconds? There's no way. There's no freaking way. Oh my god. Oh, did I make it?
You won!
I did! Okay.
Incredible!
Incredible!
Here's your prize! Enjoy! Here's a little something extra for your bonus time! You're all set to race.
Race again. Huh, that's so weird. I don't understand.
Do you wish to give me the tickets to run the time trial?
And it costs tickets instead of scrap? Weird. Maybe it's because I fixed this area the paint way and not the thinner way. It just changes the way the race works. Whoa. Honestly, this way is so much easier to do. Because the race with the breaking the targets, you actually have to avoid a whole bunch of obstacles too. Which is really awful in that car.
Wonderful!
Let's do it again. Maybe I can get a better time. Wow, that's... It's so much easier this way. I mean, the only thing you have to dodge in this
Your
is the water.
Turn.
And that
time?
Just slows you down. It doesn't, like, bump you and shoot you in another direction. Oh, God.
It's your turn. Start your engines. Ready, set, go!
Go! I'm not getting the nitrous or whatever that stuff is. Oh, but I'm going to run right into some water. Wow, I probably did better than the last time. Oh, boy, this is doing... I'm not doing so great here. This is more like what the racing is like, though. Just bump into a whole bunch of stuff. Probably not gonna win this one. Okay, let's get it, let's get it. Woo! Oh my god! Oh! It's so hazardous. It's hard enough to control without a crazy jet stream. Oh no! I didn't want to get it! I didn't want to get it! Wow, I have so much more time this time around. Oh, it's multiple laps. Ew. I bet you just keep getting more and more pins if you win. Oh my god, there's no way. 30 seconds to get all the way through here? Oh boy. Gonna get that though. It's dangerous. You gotta floor it up this ramp, man. Oh my god. Okay, this is still doable. I can still do this. I can still do this. Oh yeah!
You win! Whew. I'm dizzy just from watching! Here's a prize for you. Here's a little something extra for your bonus time.
Wow.
You're all set to race.
Tickets and pins? Wow. I don't know if I want to race again. I kind of want to see what you get from this, but... Ugh. All right, we'll just speed this one up.
Do you wish to give me the tickets to run the time trial? Wonderful!
Thank you.
Oh my god,
you
I did
won.
It!
Incredible! We have a new grand champion! The grand prize for the time trials is this handsome collectible pin. Here's a little something extra for your bonus time. You're all set to race.
Okay.
You wish to practice?
No. Wow. Going backwards along that track just is so different. Like, there's so many weird bumps in the road going backwards that, like, throw you off the track. They just, like, discombobulate you so bad. Okay, well, we did it. We got a collectible pin for winning the race 3 times. That is pretty snazzy. That's it for this playthrough and side quest, little run I'm doing. But, hey, what are you gonna throw me?
This is mine.
Oh. What's up there? A photo op?
My word, that is
well, looky there.
Photo. Adele will be pleased.
Well,
that was a great spot to take the photo, Mickey.
Okay, I guess there was a little extra side quest in there. But, the next video will be the start of my thinner playthrough, where I'm basically just going to avoid all side questing and just pretty much zerg the game like a madman. In fact, I might even cut out projectors. Well, nah, I'll leave them in. I'll leave them in. But we'll just zerg the game and do every evil thing we come across. So that should be pretty fun, and I don't think it's going to take that long, honestly, because really the main bulk of this game is just side questing, unfortunately. But anyway, yeah, that's what we'll do. So see you guys next time.